Hi friends, welcome to Easy Ways. So welcome to this new initiative of ours, which is called 5 in 10 series for current affairs. So friends, this particular series is relevant for CLAT, AILET, DU, LLB and other law entrance examinations. So friends, this is a day one of this particular lecture. And before we begin, let me tell you about the series first. So as part of this series, what we'll be doing is every day we will be solving 5 MCQs of current affairs and we will try and complete the discussion within 10 minutes, right? So friends, first thing that we know, GK and current affairs play a very important role when it comes to any examination and specifically the law entrance examinations like CLAT, AILET and DU-LLB and even other examinations, right? So friends, we need to revise those concepts. We need to be updated with the day-to-day happenings and this particular series is going to help you to stay in touch. So as I tell you, our mantra is always practice and revise, right? So let us begin with today's particular lecture. So let us start with question number one. So it says, which of the following is a media campaign which is launched by the Food Safety and Standards Authority of India, which is FSSAI, on the 1st of December 2018 for the elimination of industrially produced trans fat? Right? So friends, this was in news recently. Now you need to tell me the name of this media campaign. So I'll just give you some few seconds to think and then we'll discuss the answer. Is it Eat Right? Is it Swasth Bharat Yatra? Is it Heart Attack Rewind? Or is it Less Fat Food? Now the answer to this particular question is Heart Attack Rewind, right? So friends, this is a media campaign which has been started by the Food Safety and Standards Authority of India. Now this particular authority deals with the specific regulations when it comes to food safety in India, right? We will read about this organization in the coming section. Now this particular target that this particular institution has set is actually to eliminate trans fat in India by the year 2022. So this is again important for us. Okay, so when you talk about trans fats, these are actually very harmful for the body and consuming too much of trans fats lead to cardiovascular diseases, right? So and that is why the Food Safety Authority in India has decided to eliminate the usage of these trans fats in our food, right? Now, there's one other important information, friends, that the World Health Organization, okay, this is important. This organization has also decided to eliminate the use of trans fat, but the target year that WHO has kept for this is 2023, right? So you can see that we are targeting to eliminate trans fat a year before than the World Health Organization. So friends, now this particular media campaign that we are talking about, that is Heart Attack Rewind, basically it is an awareness campaign, right? And it would also offer certain strategies to the citizens to avoid the trans fat contained food and give them with healthier alternatives, okay? We will make them aware about the health hazards, okay? So this particular campaign, as it is a media campaign, we can see it is going to be broadcasted in 17 languages. It will run for a period of 4 weeks, okay, on major digital platforms, as we all know, right? And FSSAI actually plans to come to a percentage which is lower than 2% use of trans fat by the year 2022. So when we say we are going to eliminate trans fat, it is not practically possible to make it zero, but yes, we can make it to a meager level of less than 2%. Right now, the usage of this in India's food supply is actually less than 5%, okay? So we need to bring it to this much level. So now talking about World Health Organization's target, as I told you, WHO has set the target to eliminate it by the year 2023. So note this down, friends. This is also important for us from the perspective of examination. Now, the other important thing that is needed for us is about this nodal authority. Okay, now what is FSSAI? So basically, it is a statutory agency. So when we say statutory agency, that means it has come into effect by the passing of a law. Okay, so it derives its power from a statute which is called a law, okay, and that particular law is Food Safety and Standards Act 2006. Okay, so this important point you need to note, right? This act can also be a probable question for us. Next, it operates under the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, the second important point that you need to note, right? And the CEO of FSAAI, presently it is Mr. Pavan Kumar Agarwal. Again, an important point for you guys to note. So note this down. Now, one question for you guys. Tell me where is the headquarters of World Health Organization? Kindly mention the answers in the comment section. Let us make this series interactive. Now, the second question, friends, which of the following personalities has become the first Indian, right, to win the coveted International Shooting Sports Federation's Blue Cross? So this is an award, friends, and it has recently been conferred on an Indian. You need to tell me the answer for it. So the correct answer is Abhinav Bindra. So he has been conferred with this coveted prize. So this Blue Cross is the highest recognition that is offered by ISSF. What is this ISSF? It is International Shooting Sport Federation. Note this point. It is a parent body of international shooting. Okay. Now I'm going to even tell you the details about it in the coming section. So this particular award, which is Blue Cross, okay, it is awarded for outstanding contribution to the sport of shooting. So this is also important. They can also ask you a question like Blue Cross is an award given in which of the following fields, right? So its answer is shooting. Okay. So this particular ISSF is headquartered in Munich, Germany. Again, a probable question. So you can see here, friends, when we are dealing with one particular question, we can see so many probable questions can be solved. So that is why this discussion is very important, right? And Mr. Abhinav Bindra, as I told you, has become the first Indian to be awarded this Blue Cross prize. And Mr. Abhinav Bindra is still India's only individual Olympic gold medalist, right? He won an Olympic gold in the year 2008. Now, another question for you guys for today. Just tell me when, in which place were the 2008 Olympics held? Okay, so two questions. So the first question that you need to answer is the headquarters of WHO. Kindly give your answers in the comment section below. The second important question, in 2008, where were the Olympic Games conducted? Right? Now, the third question for discussion, International Day for the Abolition of Slavery is observed on which date? So, friends, for any examination, specifically for the law examinations that we are dealing, we do get questions on important days and weeks. So, we need to be aware of each and every day. So, how is it possible? Through revision, right? So the answer for this particular question is 2nd of December. So 2nd of December is celebrated or it is recognized as International Day for the Abolition of Slavery, a very big menace or a threat to the entire world today. So friends, this particular yearly event, okay, was organized by the United Nations General Assembly. So basically, why 2nd of December? Because on this particular date, the UN General Assembly approved a convention. So when I say convention, you can just say a guideline, okay, wherein all the nations agree to certain terms and conditions, okay. So the guidelines were on United Nations Convention for the Suppression of the Traffic in Persons and of the Exploitation of the Prostitution of Others. So this was the convention. You do not need to go detail into it. Just understand that 2nd December is celebrated as this particular International Day for the Abolition of Slavery, right? Obviously, the focus of this day is what? To eradicate the contemporary forms of slavery. What are those? The forced labor, child labor, and trafficking, right? Now, next fourth question, the 23rd Chief Election Commissioner of India is. This is very important question, friends. Kindly note it down. Important appointments are always asked in the examination. So the answer is, it is Mr. Sunil Arora. He has been appointed as the recent Chief Election Commissioner of India. So friends, he has taken up this charge and he has taken it from the previous Chief Election Commissioner Om Prakash Rawat. So he has succeeded him. This is also important. Kindly make note of it. Now he will be holding the post of Chief Election Commissioner till April 2021. So note this down as well. Initially, he was in the role of the Election Commissioner and then he has been upgraded now to the CEC, that is Chief Election Commissioner. Now, friends, very important, this body, election commission, okay, even in constitution, when we are reading about that, you will also see that this body is an important point of reference for us. Now, in India, we know that free and fair elections are conducted. It may be for the state assemblies or it may be for the parliament, right? So to conduct and foresee those elections, we have a permanent body. This body is independent and it is a constitutional body, okay? So when I say constitutional body, that means it derives its power from the Indian constitution. There is a specific article in the constitution which mentions about election commission, right? And it was established on 25th of January 1950. Kindly make note of this. So friends, just one revision here. When we were having a look at FSSAI, we saw that that was a statutory body. That means it derives its power from statute, that is law. But this election commission is a constitutional body. It derives its power from the Indian constitution, right? What is its major aim? Its aim is to conduct elections in India, right, at various levels. It may be at the level of parliament, state legislature, and also for the offices of president and vice president of India. Make note of this, because we know that for electing president and vice president also, there are elections that take place. Okay, so we will be dealing with all these concepts when we start with our lectures on Indian constitution. Then which article? Friends, kindly note this down. Very important. It is according to Article 324 of the Indian Constitution. Make note of this, right? And you can see that this is an all India body. And as we told, it conducts elections at the central government and state government. Now comes a very important question. Does it take care of the elections taking place at the panchayat and municipalities in the states? The answer is no. Only these two elections, okay, that is the elections to panchayats and municipalities, are taken care of by a separate state election commission. We will read about this when we have a news related to this particular state election commissions in the further lectures. Next, friends, composition of this commission, very important. The election commission has three members. One is the chief election commissioner, and just now we have seen that who has been appointed, Mr. Sunil Arora, right? There are two election commissioners as well, and all these personalities or all these appointments are made by the President of India. Very important. Note this point. You may get a direct question that the election commissioner, the chief election commissioner is appointed by which of the following authorities in India? So the answer is President of India. Kindly make note of this. Then you need to understand the conditions of service, like tenure of office. All this is decided by a particular act. You can see here that the act is the Chief Election Commissioner and Other Election Commissioners Conditions of Service Act 1991. So what does the act say? Who has the power to select chief election commissioner and election commissioners? It is the president. One important point. Next, you need to know the tenures. What is a tenure? 6 years. Make note of this. This can also be a probable question for us, or up to the age of 65 years, whichever is earlier. Okay. Now, they have the same status and they receive the pay and perks as available to the judges of the Supreme Court of India. The next important point, the chief election commissioner can be removed only from the office only through the accusation by parliament, right? So what we need to remember, who has the power to select? The president. What is the tenure? 6 years or up to the age of 65 years. Okay, so these two, three points you need to keep in mind. So the last question for discussion, friends, Excope India 2018, the Air Force exercises between India and the US have been held in which of the following states of India, right? Now the answer to this particular question is West Bengal. So this exercise has taken place in West Bengal. So friends, this Scope India is a very important exercise. It takes place between the Air Force of India and United States of America, right? And you can see that this exercise started in 2004. For the first time, it took place in Gwalior. And now this exercise in the year 2018 is important for the reason because it is being held after a gap of 8 years. The last exercise took place in 2010. So please remember this name, COPE exercise. Okay, you might get a direct question that this particular exercise takes place between the Air Force of which of the following two nations. Right? And now, friends, you need to tell me the third question I'm going to put forth for you guys today, that tell me the name of the exercise that takes place between the navies of India and US, right? So this you need to answer, right? So now the first question that I asked you was, where is the headquarters of WHO? The second question was, 2008 Olympics games took place in which country? Okay, you need to tell me this, the exact location you need to mention. And the third question, obviously, the naval exercise that takes place between India and the US, the name of it, right? So please mention the answers of it in the comment section. Let us make this series interactive. Let us discuss a lot of questions. So friends, let me just quickly tell you about our courses, as telling you how important GK and current affairs for law examinations. So we have come up with a mock test series for GK and current affairs for CLAT 2019. We will give you 45 mock tests with proper schedule, and it would cover from the months of June 2018 to May 1st week 2019. There would also be additional quizzes that would be provided. For static JK, you will get some sheets on each of the topics that are relevant for our examination, and you would also get questions for practice. So friends, what is the pricing? So the test series is for rupees 3000, but right now we are running a discount for our first 100 subscribers. So there's 25% off, and you can avail this test series for a price of rupees 2250, the validity from December 2018 to May 2019. So friends, till then, we have come to the end of this particular lecture wherein we discuss five important questions, and you can mail us at mail@easyway@gmail.com. You can also give us a call at 8968984790 in case of any queries. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you, friends, and keep revising.